Good morning, Mountainside friends. I'm so glad to be back together today. Let's stand up and sing some songs together. Guys, this is a song that's new, but I think you'll like it. You might have sung a song called This Little Light of Mine in Sunday school, and this is kind of similar to that. But you gotta get up because we gotta stomp and clap at the same time. Can you do that? Stomp and clap at the same time. Ready? Let's do it.
You guys stomp your feet like that?
Let's clap
together.
It's tricky.
That's it.
Stomp, clap, stomp, clap.
Clapping on the back.
Good job.
All right, sing this real
quiet. Now, even when I'm afraid.
Even when I'm afraid, I'm gonna let it shine. Even when I'm afraid, I'm gonna let it shine. Even when I'm afraid, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
Okay, sing with me. Let our light shine when we tell everybody that Jesus is alive. Great job singing. All right, welcome back to Bible Time, guys. I'm glad you're here today. Last time we talked about how Jesus died on the cross, but then he came back to life and he rose again. But he hung out with his disciples for a while and then he went where? Back up into heaven. You're right. So the disciples did what Jesus said and they went to tell everybody about Jesus, everyone around the world. But some people didn't like that. This was a man named Saul. And even though he was in a church and he read the Bible, he did not believe in Jesus. He didn't believe that Jesus was God's son. And so he said to the other religious men, if anyone believes in Jesus or is a follower of Jesus, I'm going to put them in prison or I'm going to hurt them or I'm even going to kill them. And they agreed because they didn't believe in Jesus either. So even though they were in the temple where they were worship God, they still didn't believe that Jesus was God's son. So they wanted to hurt people that followed Jesus. So Saul was on his way to a city called Damascus. And he was riding his horse and he was going there because he was going to find anybody that believed in Jesus so he could put them in prison and hurt them or even kill them. So as he was riding along, a big bright light shined on Saul. And he was like, what just happened? And the voice said, Saul, why are you hurting me? And Saul was very confused. Saul said, I don't know who you are. Who are you? He said to this bright light and this voice. And the voice said, who are you? And the voice said, I am Jesus. Now, how would Jesus be hurting? Or how would Saul be hurting Jesus? Because Jesus was back in heaven. You know what? I think Saul was hurting the people that Jesus loved. He was hurting the people that followed Jesus, and that made him very sad. Just like you're sad if someone you love gets hurt, Jesus was saying, you're hurting me because you're hurting the people that I love. He said, stop hurting the people that I love. And Saul was a little bit scared from the light and from hearing his voice. And so Saul got up to go into the city, but he couldn't see. That light was so bright that now he was blind. And he had to have people help him into the city because he couldn't see. But the light and Jesus had said, go into the city and I'll tell you what to do when you get there. So Saul obeyed and he came with some helpers into the city of Damascus. You see, they're selling, looks like they're selling some fruit. He didn't even want to eat. He was so upset. And he wasn't sure what to do. So they asked to go in the house, and they were able to go into the house. There's a little piggy, and there's a little doggy. Isn't he cute? And there's the city of Damascus where they were selling everything. It's a little mouse in his food. Silly. So Saul, even though he was blind, went to the city and waited to see what was going to happen. Well, meanwhile, there was a man named Ananias. He was someone that loved Jesus very much. And Jesus said, hey, Ananias, I want you to go see someone named Saul. And Ananias thought, Saul? He's the one that's hurt people. Huh? And Jesus said, I want you to go to Saul and put your hands on him so his eyes will be all better. And Ananias thought, Saul, I don't want to go there. If he knows I love Jesus, he'll hurt me, put me in prison, maybe even kill me. But you know what? He knew that he had to do what Jesus asked him to do. Look at that little kitty sleeping in the window. Isn't he silly? Looks like he's sleepy, doesn't he? He's tired. Poor little kitty cat. He must have his pet, like our pet. Oh, he's dreaming of fish. Look at him. Shh. All right, so. Thank you. It's on my phone somewhere. On the iPad. Okay. So Ananias was still a little afraid. But Saul wants to arrest your followers, Jesus. He will hurt me. He doesn't want people telling about you. And Jesus knew that. Oh, there's a diamond. Let me grab that diamond. Good job. And there's that little kitty cat sleeping again, isn't he? Aw, he's so cute. Oh, whoops, he fell out of the window, silly cat. And look, there's a mouse too. Do you see the little mouse? Here was Ananias saying, are you sure that I should go see Saul? And Jesus said, yep, I'm going to use Saul to tell everybody about me. And Ananias thought, really? Because Saul's hurting people that love you. But I will do what you say. So Ananias went to pray for Saul and put his hands on his eyes, just like Jesus told him. And so he got there and he said, hey, Saul, it's me, Ananias. And I think he was probably a little bit afraid. So Ananias went to pray for Saul. He was a little afraid, but Jesus had told him, remember, to pray and put his hands on Saul's eyes. And so he said, Jesus sent me so that your eyes can see again. And so Saul was here and his hurt eyes, he couldn't see, but Ananias came and he put his hands on Saul just like Jesus told him to. Let's see what happens. As soon as he did, Saul could see again. He was so excited. Even the little doggy was excited that he could see again. He was excited. Everybody was excited. Wow. Ananias, God had used Ananias to help heal Saul's eyes. Let's see what question Ananias said. Who did Jesus want to use to tell people all over the world about him? Did he want to tell the person that worked in the church? Did he want to use Saul? Or did he want to use Ananias? Remember, Jesus said, Ananias, I want to use Saul to tell people all over the world about me. And Ananias wasn't so sure about that because Saul at that time was hurting people. But Jesus said, I'm going to use Saul. So, Jesus changed Saul from the inside out. Instead of wanting to hurt Jesus' followers, he wanted to tell everybody about Jesus. So he decided to change his name. He said, you know what? I don't want to be Saul anymore because Saul hurt Jesus' followers. I want to be called Paul. And Jesus said, you can be called Paul because you're going to tell everybody about Jesus. So everyone was a little nervous when Saul came around because they thought, isn't that Saul, the one that hurt Jesus? And they said, yes. But now he believes that Jesus is God's son. And he tells everybody about Jesus. He told lots and lots of people about Jesus. And lots of people learned about Jesus and came to know Jesus because Paul decided to obey. Aren't you glad he had a changed heart? Kind of like Zacchaeus, remember when he was doing bad things? But God still loved him and said, you're not a bad person. You're just making bad choices. I love you. And that's what he said to Saul, who became Paul. And Paul went everywhere telling people about Jesus. And we can do that too, can't we? We can tell everyone about Jesus. Saul's life was changed by Jesus, and his name was also changed to Paul. Is that true or false? Did you say true? You're right. He was changed by Jesus, and now his name was Paul, and he went to tell everybody about Jesus. We can do that too. Let's pray and thank God. Ready? One, two, three. Thank you, God, for loving us so much. Thank you that you sent your son Jesus to die for us. Thank you that we can tell everybody about Jesus just like Paul did. In Jesus' name, amen. Good job today. All right, remember last time we learned a song called Get Up, Get Up, Get Up and Tell the World, because that's what Jesus said before he went to heaven. He said, tell the world that Jesus is alive. Sing this with me. You got to stand up. Welcome to Alphabet Time. This week we are learning about plants and flowers, so I brought some of my flower friends here. How about we make a garden? All right, let's get our hands ready. You ready? This is my garden. I'll rake it with care. Can you do that? Then take some little flower seeds and plant them in there. The sun will shine and the rain will fall, and my garden will bloom and grow straight and tall. Did you do that with me? Great, let's try it again. Ready? This is my garden. I'll rake it with care. Then take some little flower seeds and plant them in there. The sun will shine, warm up your seeds, and the rain will fall, and my garden will bloom and grow straight and tall. Great job. Speaking of flowers, I brought some parts of a flower here. I don't know if you know the parts of a flower, but let's see if we can put our flower together. Usually the flower is kind of on top, right? And this part has dirt on it. So that's gonna go in the bottom. And then we know that this part kind of goes up at the top, and then we have a long stick that goes all the way down to the ground. Now let's talk about what the parts of a flower are. We know that the top part is called the blossom or the flower. And we know that these are what? These are called the leaves. Those fall down in the fall. They change color and we have to rake them up when they come down from the trees. And these are the leaves on the flower. And then there's this long stick that goes all the way down to the bottom. And that's called the stem. The stem helps bring up all the nutrients from the soil and the ground all the way up to the flower. And this part that's under the ground that you don't usually see because there's dirt covering it is called the roots. So if you pull up a plant or you pull up a flower, you will always, or sometimes even the weeds, you will see the roots down in the bottom of the, into the ground. And they dig, they grow into the soil in the ground so they can get the nutrients and the water, and then they pull it up the stem and it climbs up the stem into the flower and into the leaves. So those are our parts of a flower. All right, we're gonna move this flower over here so we can do another activity with flowers. All right, we've been doing some beginning sounds and some ending sounds. And so today I am gonna think about the word wig. Wig. What sound does wig start with? Wuh. Good job. What letter is that? W says wuh, right? All right, now let's do our ending sound. Ready? Wig. G. Did you hear that? Let's do it again. Wig. G. That has the g sound. What letter is that? G. You got it. So here's our wig, and we know it starts with W and ends with G, but today we have to figure out the middle sound. So let's think about wig. It has three sounds. W, I, G. W, I, G. So the middle sound is I. W, I, I, I. What letter makes that sound? Iguana. I, letter I makes that sound. Did you say that? Good job, there's our wig. All right, how about the word jet? What sound does jet start with? J. Right, what letter makes the j sound? J. All right, let's do the ending. Jet, t. Do you hear the t? That's the letter T. So we've got j at the beginning and t at the end. Now let's see what sound is in the middle. J, et. Eh, eh, eh. What sound makes the eh, eh, eh sound? Yeah, E, letter E. Good. Let's do one more. All right, how about the word, hat? We know that hat starts with letter H. T, 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 ends with letter T, hat. And what's in the middle? At. Ah. What makes the ah sound? Letter I. Oh, looks like we have one more. All right. Zip, zip. Starts with the letter Z, like zebra, right? And ends with P, zip. P. Now let's see what sound goes in the middle. Z, I, I. Zip, zip. There we go. You made all of our flowers. Great job. All right, before we go today, let's read a book. And this is called Plant the Tiny Seed. All right. Plant the Tiny Seed. There's magic in this tiny seed. Press it down and count to three. So get your finger ready. Let's press it down. One, two, three. Did you count to three with me? Good job, pushing down. Oh, looks like we have to plant some more seeds. All right, let's count to four this time. Get your finger ready. Ready? One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. All right, now let's see what happens. What else do we need? Oh, wiggle your fingers to add some water. We've got to add some water to our seeds. That's enough. Next, rub the sun to make it hotter. Can you rub the sun? Good job. Plants need, oh, look, what's coming up? Those are little sprouts. They're starting to come up with the sun and the water. Tap the cloud and wish for more rain. Can you tap it? Tap, tap, tap. Good job. Our sprouts need some more sun and rain. Oh, there it is. Clap to bring the sun again. Can you clap? Clap your hands together. Our little sprouts are starting to grow. Ah, now they have the sun. Oh, I see a worm. Do you see a worm with its tail? And look what's coming up over here. Uh-oh. We gotta shoo the bugs away. Shoo the hungry snail. Don't eat our plants. Shoo, shoo snail. Now we've got some plants starting to grow. Tell the little bud good night. Now see, we started with a little seed. It grew into a little sprout. Now it's into a plant and it has a little bud. What do you think that bud's gonna do? It's gonna grow into a flower. Tell the bud good night. Good night, bud. Wake up. What is it? Oh, we have a beautiful purple flower. I wonder what color these buds will be. Let's see. Bzzz. Tap the cloud again. We need a little bit more rain for our plants. Oh, look. I bet I can tell what color that one's going to be. Oh, I was right. It's another rain shower. And now we have a beautiful red flower and a purple flower. What color do you think that one's going to grow into? It's our little blossom. Our little bud's gonna grow into a blossom. Let's see. Oh, look at that, a beautiful orange flower. Can we touch the blossoms? One, two, three, good job. Oh, looks who came to eat from the flowers, little hummingbirds. Now we gotta jiggle the plants to scatter the seeds. Let's see if the seeds from the flowers will scatter. Yep, the seeds from the middle of the flower are scattering. All right, the purple flower needs to cut off. Can we snip it? Get your fingers, snip, snip, snip. We're gonna snip the stem. Good job. Oh, look, now another blossom can grow. Close your eyes, wave your hands in the air. Let's see what happens. Oh, look, beautiful. There's magic everywhere. We know it's not magic, isn't it? It's God. God making those flowers grow. Look, here's another blossom, and we've got our bees that are helping the flowers grow and our beautiful butterflies. It grew from a little seed to a sprout to a plant to a bud to a blossom. Isn't that neat? That's called Plant the Tiny Seed. Great job listening to me today. Have a great day.